Welcome back to the basement.
The friendliest place on YouTube. Peter's going to try to traipse across this ledge here without falling off in order to procure for us.
Dang it!
I think Mario will warn you with like the "I'm gonna fall" thing. So I need to look for that and then go. Basement Let's Play.
Yes, Peter, why do you think Basement Let's Play is valuable?
How do I...
X. You hold X to get him into the spinny thing.
There it is.
And then you let go when it's time.
Yeah, I pressed X, but I didn't hold it. Okay, so in the beginning...
In the beginning, the Lord created the heavens and the earth and Basement Let's Play.
Well, the basement was a variety channel.
Right.
And we played old games and new games. And then it became clear that Breath of the Wild and Tears of the Kingdom were the bread and butter of the basement. But we didn't want to... Oh, there's a railing here. So I can walk as far as I want that way.
Can you skinny through it, maybe?
I think I'm on it now. Yeah.
Yep.
And we didn't want to give up that variety and the ability to play older games.
And the ability to play whatever we want.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice.
I mean... Like, I've played the original Legend of Zelda on Basement Let's Play probably 4 times.
Mm-hmm.
And on the basement as well. Okay, I don't understand what this airplane is going
to
do for
me. Well, it's going to get us to the other side. There's a door over there. I'm not good at this airplane thing, so I'm glad you're doing it. Well, I realized a very important thing about...
What am I... Oh, onto this. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, can I keep going?
Because
I'm gonna lose my train here.
Yep.
So that was sort of the beginning of it. But now, if people don't know, have we been here before? No, we haven't.
Different stairwell room.
Oh, look. I could get that key.
But can you? Oh, you had to be smart. Now you're stuck here forever, though.
I think I'll just have to fall. Okay, there we go.
We have been in this room. That stinks.
Oh, it'll probably be quicker to get back up there than it was to originally get back up there.
True.
For those of you who don't know, as often as once a week, we will watch an episode of Futurama together just to do something that like is good for Ted and I's friendship.
It is.
Where we're not
awesome.
On.
Glad we do that.
And I do think that like Basement Let's Play kind of served that function as well. Before that, even though we are on, it's not planned, it's not polished, it's just us playing games and getting lost and finding ourselves and, you know, it's not efficient. It's just Let's Play. This is the exit, isn't it?
Right. It's not meant to be content that is consumed in the sense that, like, it'll probably perform well on YouTube. It's meant to be more of, like, it's almost like a behind-the-scenes kind of channel.
One of the ways that I enjoy its existence is that every month I'm watching the basement's revenue, and then when the month closes, I know what it is, and then when YouTube pays us, it's like $65 more than I was expecting because of Basement Let's Play.
That's right.
I don't know. If we want to do something, it's not going to work on one of the other channels. This is our spot. We can dump whatever we want here. How do I get back to where we were?
Go through the purple door, then go up. There's got to be a better way, but yeah, go up the green elevator.
So I don't know. I guess it supplies us with it's a lot of intangible or implicit value that it offers us and
I think that's
others.
I think that kind of ends up being my answer too. And whenever Lisa has asked that question in the past, she's not trying to say you should definitely stop. She's
right.
Because that's the thing that I just learned about people who wonder. They're not prescribing anything.
Yeah.
They're literally just asking a hard question.
Right. Well, have you thought about this? Because I'm thinking about it. And it seems to me, yeah.
However,
I do think that if push came to shove and we did have to like trim time, that, you know, what we're not going to do is spend less time on the basement.
Right.
And, I don't know.
That would
so
be a bad
like
business decision.
We could take a year off of, if for example, we had a channel where videos only came out in October.
Mm-hmm.
We could skip a year of that if we needed that time. I would rather do that than skip Basement Let's Play.
Yep.
But, you know, maybe best Basement Let's Play goes to 2 videos a week or 1 video a week. This was progress, right? To the left was getting the key. To the right is progress.
Yes. There was also a little mushroom badge that was down on that.
Oh, is that a badge?
I think it might be. And she said there's a badge that you got to find in order to beat the bad guy. So maybe that's it. But
so
I don't know how to get it.
Fall here.
Here?
I think it's this way. Nope.
Oh, you gotta
it's the
fall
other way and then
backwards and then wiggle through.
Yep. Saw that as well.
Yeah, the intangibles, I think, for me, are really where it's at. But, I mean, because she was just, you know, she's like, why don't you, because you guys are going to play, because I was like, we're going to play Basement Let's Play type stuff anyway.
Right.
No matter what, even if we never recorded it, we would play this stuff.
And it's not like it's taking a lot of extra time to record it. We're just recording us playing what we would have played anyway.
Right. So then she asked the question, okay, that's fair. So then why don't you just make that what's on Patreon? Because if it's just there, then, you know, why wouldn't you do something like that? And I was like,
we could move some of it to Patreon.
Yeah, we could.
What did I do? Was that a badge?
Yeah, it was a life something. Go back. Oh.
Well, we're on badges.
Never mind, that was a gear. It was a life mushroom. Restores 10 HP. That was it? That's dumb.
Well, it wasn't much backtracking to pick that up and get back here.
Okay. But, it was just... And just so I'm clear, like, Lisa is not trying to say, like, you guys should put everything behind a paywall or whatever.
No,
she just,
yeah.
She just likes asking the questions. But, yeah, I think when it comes down to it, for me, it's a lot of intangible benefits that come from what Peter and I would be doing anyway with... I mean, besides playing the games... I would say it probably only takes like 15 more minutes of work, maybe 20 more minutes of work a week to get the videos out.
Right, because I put them all in DaVinci Resolve.
And that's Peter working, so it really doesn't even matter. I'm kidding.
No, we've got a good... Dude, with my tenacity,
yes,
me editing the stuff that like gives you 15 minutes back so that, you know, the... higher performing stuff can have a little more polish is an excellent
thing that you just pointed out, because that the little 15 minute things, those drain me a lot, which is silly.
Yeah.
They're not hard.
Well, it's not silly. It's
silly that it drains me, because you'd look at it and say like, oh, it's just a little tiny thing.
That drains lots of people though. And to understand that, yeah, I took the test, by the way. I am officially discernment and tenacity.
Yep. That's cool. If you don't know what we're talking about, we're actually referring to a book by a guy named Peter Scazzaro. No, that's not his name. What's the guy's name?
I don't know.
It's a book called The 6 Types of Working Genius. It was really interesting little read. Peter and I had a nice little business conversation about where we land on the kinds of work that we like to do. And it's like, talks about the kind of work that you like to do, regardless of what industry you're in. Like, you could be in marketing, or you could be in product development, or you could be in, you know, lots of different stuff. Our case, it's content creation and, you know, running an entertainment business, essentially.
Ow, 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 ow.
And, we kind of found out, you know, we are a little low on a couple areas when it comes to what? That was hurt you really bad?
Yeah, well, I'm down to 2. Can I use
I don't know if we have any attacky items, but...
Well...
But yeah, you could use a... Well, don't use that. That's brand new. What's the honey syrup do? Oh, that...
FP.
Yeah, just give yourself...
I'm not sure that Koopa can use a mushroom on Mario for his turn when he's laying on his back. That's 2 variables I'm unsure of, so...
I think he's...
I want to be careful.
But, I'll just give you y'all a quick little sort of rundown of the 6 types of working genius, because I think it's really interesting. So it kind of goes along the workflow of like of how an idea forms in an organization all the way until it like finally comes to fruition and finally like lands. And so the first step along the process is wonder, somebody kind of asking the hard questions. Like Lisa does that a lot for me and in my life in general, but she's actually sort of served that purpose a lot, I think, in the basement. Behind the scenes,
yeah.
She'll ask a question that'll make me think.
Yeah.
And then the next step in the process is finding solutions to those tough questions. That's called invention. And I really like to do that. That gives me a ton of energy to do that kind of work.
Mm.
But that same kind of thing can actually drain somebody who just really doesn't like doing that kind of thing. Great example of that is Lisa. If you ask her to be in a brainstorming meeting, she's like, this is the worst. I hate coming up with ideas. How about you give me ideas and I'll kind of tell you which ones are bad? You know?
Okay.
And that's discernment. That's the next step along the process. For people who are really energized by discernment, they like to see like a list of 10 ideas and go, ooh, that one's good, that one's bad, that one's good.
Yeah!
Dude, bingo!
Bingo!
Let's go bingo bango.
Dude, these guys are toast. HP is full.
That was a good get.
Dude, our crowd stinking loves us.
Yeah, bingo. They're toads, too. They're not even dirty Koopas. PowerShell, do it. Oh, good.
Oh.
Phew. Good golly, Miss Molly. And now you could do sweet treat whenever you need to. Yeah, these guys are gone. Then discernment is next in the process. Peter is really, really good at and energized by discernment. And then what's the one after that one? Galvanizing?
Yep. It spells widget, WIDGET.
Oh, that's right. So galvanizing is kind of like rallying the troops, and it has to do with kind of holding people to task. And I like certain parts of it. I like positively motivating people. Other people really, like I have a cousin who is, he's really smart business guy. He likes the holding people to task on a little bit more of like the stick side. He doesn't do it in a mean way, but he's not afraid to kind of like confront and get in somebody's face and be like, hey, you're not pulling your weight, man. You really gotta, and I like that kind of thought of having to have that conversation.
Oh my gosh, that makes me wither.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
So that's kind of like, that's one area that maybe, you know.
That is a quote frustration for me.
If we had like a staff of like 15 people, we would want to make sure somebody.
Yeah, that someone was a galvanizer.
Who had authority was a galvanizer. Who was energized by that.
Look how the camera doesn't change here.
Oh, that is really cool.
And you get to see it from the outside. Look, you can see the whole.
That's just beautiful.
Although the parallax scrolling doesn't make as much sense with the castle and the background. It's okay.
Oh, is it getting darker and cloudier? Did you find the badge?
If we go back down, will it get sunnier?
I don't think you found
it. It does!
I don't think you found the badge, Peter.
Uh-oh. Well, maybe we're not done. Maybe the badge is up here.
I feel like you're going to the boss room. This feels like endgame to me. Might be the end. Of the whole game.
No, wait.
That's the beginning of the game. Then after galvanizing is enablement, which is the thing that I really get a lot of energy from, too.
You are good at that.
And that is like, you like to get your hands dirty and kind of get in the mix with everybody else and helping them to get things done. Like, I would much rather come alongside somebody and work with them on a project and tell them to do it and hold them to task about it.
Yes.
So even when I do kind of like encourage, let's say Micah to do like an edit thing that he hasn't done before, I'm kind of like, how can I help you? How can I help you make this easy? Like,
right.
There are a lot of conversations about, you know, are you, like,
and if you don't have a ton of time for it, it's actually really nice when then they're like, no, I can do it. I can, you know. Like, they're self-galvanizers, so you don't have to galvanize others.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Dude, I've been thinking about this with my family, too. I am definitely, like, I think Kelsey and I are both bad at galvanizing, and we're constantly having to galvanize our kids into doing, you know, their chores or, I don't know, cleaning up after their dishes, after dinner, that kind of thing.
Yeah, so galvanizing for you is a frustration. It drains you a lot.
Yep.
For me, it's a competency. Like, I'm not particularly drained by it.
Yeah, it's better.
But I'm not energized by it either. So in our house, I end up kind of like rallying the kids. I'm like, hey, all right, here's everybody's chores for the day. Let's make sure these all feel like really good and fair between everybody. And they're all kind of like in agreement. And they're all like, all right, let's do it. Man, break. You know?
Okay, yeah.
And so it's like, it feels really good. And then the conversations where it's like, hey, you didn't do your chores, like that's the part where Lisa and I have to kind of go like, oh, do you want to take this one? Or
Yeah.
But either way. And then the last one on the list is tenacity, which Peter is super great at. It's that last little, like, 5% of every project that I hate doing.
Hey, Ted, I found a typo in the description of an old Basement Let's Play video.
And then you fix it. You're not like,
yeah,
Ted,
I wouldn't actually tell
you
about
it.
I'd just be like, oh, man, okay, I got to push changes here.
But it's so weird. Like, a personality like mine has a lot of uncompleted projects because tenacity is just kind of like, it's a frustration for me. I was thinking about this with video games, too. When we first started doing The Basement.
Oh, yeah. You're like, I'm excited to finish this game because I like it and I've played it, but I didn't finish it.
I've got
it
to 75% on a lot of games. That last 25%, I'm like, I'm kind of done with this now. I'm bored with it. I want something new, something fresh.
How we doing with... We got Headbonk and Tattle. Tattle might be really useful for...
At least the first try, so we can see what the deal is with
them. But... Oh, you can use stuff. I only used 4 of those 5, but that's okay. That's
good. And we've got a sweet treat that you can use in the middle of the battle. Maybe we already found it. Maybe it's the attack effects one.
I'm doing that. The attack effects is the one that does it.
Well, is Power Bounce the one that we just got?
Power Bounce jumps on multiple. Oh, no. It's stronger. Oh, Close Call would be good to have, though.
I'm trying to remember which ones we got in here. Because, like she said, there's one in the place that will really help you. Maybe it's Close Call. I don't know. I feel like that's not really.
Did we get that? This is the one we got in here. Oh, yeah. We may have gotten one. Because she said you may have already gotten it. So it could have been weeks ago when we got it.
It could be multi-bounce. I feel like Power Bounce might be smart to use. But I don't know what it does, though. What does Power Bounce do? Multiple hits on one guy?
Where is this to use Power Bounce?
Oh, thanks.
Oh.
Lets you jump on one enemy multiple times. That might be it. Because it's like, it's one boss. So you can hit him like 3 times.
Right, that's better than multi-bounce. This feels tempting, but I don't know what we take off
that one's
to make it happen, because I like that one. I know, but it's just tempting to... Okay, we're going to resave.
Options. Yeah.
Ooh, okay, we got one attempt in this episode. Okay. Yeah, we got time for it.
Everybody breathe. Okay, stop breathing.
I
breathe again.
Okay, inhale. Okay, exhale. Okay, make sure your heart's beating.
Oh, he's like an evil Yoshi.
I am an origami paper dragon.
Oh, yeah. He's got 2 sides.
Yeah.
Didn't expect more to come to steal the treasure I protect.
It reminds me of like those balsa wood 3D puzzles.
Oh, yeah. Like the dinosaur
things. I
liked
those when I was a kid. I had a stegosaurus one of those.
That's foolish, I fear. Do you really think you can beat me?
Yeah, I think we could.
But you're so small, and you don't appear tasty. I suppose you might make a good snack.
I haven't taken a bath since Mario 4.
After gnawing at the bottoms of your feet, I'll saute you to crispy goodness and gobble you down headfirst!
First, I'll bite your toes, and then I'll eat you from the top down, all the way to your ankles. Because your feet are gone.
So the ankles are really the dessert.
I like to save the ankles for last. It's my Achilles heel.
Can't flee this fight.
Oh, Peter didn't hear my really good joke.
Oh, I forgot to switch to Goomba.
It's fine. It's fine. You can switch in the middle of battle, maybe.
Okay, we're going to try some normal stuff here. Actually, let's do a power bounce.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
Well, that didn't work very well.
Might not be it.
Do we have a fire flower?
No, yeah, nothing.
Can we put him to sleep?
Probably not. I wouldn't waste it. Do shell toss.
Oh, his feet.
Maybe that's
why
he's going
to start with his toes.
Yeah, maybe that's what the whole idea is.
Oh, I can't believe I made the mistake that Nintendo designed me to make. You got to look and see if there are more than one target.
Ah! 3?
I guarded it, but it did 3.
Yeah, knock out his toes and then stomp on his head multiple times.
Yeah, and then finish with his ankles. That's just as multiple enemies.
So are you saying that we have to finish with his ankles? Ah, that's our Achilles heel. There, he heard it now.
Wait, did you say that again? Before?
You missed it, though. You were too focused on the game, which is good. You should be.
Ah!
Oh, he flattened you. Wait, no, he just knocked you over, I guess.
Yeah, we are paper after all. Man, I wish I had a fire flower. Okay.
Well, he's probably allergic to fire.
Tactics. Oh.
Swap partner?
Is that going to take a...
there you go.
That's going to take a turn, but that's okay.
No, she can go.
I mean, it took Mario's turn.
Oh. Tattle.
Once the cursor's inside the circle.
They've got no data on this.
That's Hooktail.
HP 20, attack 1, appears in Hooktail Castle. Okay.
Defense 1. So our two attacks only do 1.
Okay. Max HP is 20, attack is 5. She'll stomp and munch on you, and she has more dragonish attack. Fiery, stinky breath. Tricky, especially when she's losing, and she'll try to fool you into being merciful.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, one more thing. She hates things that start with F and end with... We forgot about Frog.
Frog?
Yeah, she hates things. There's something related to that somewhere
supposedly
in the castle.
Supposedly there's something related to that
did
somewhere
we find
in this
it?
Castle.
She hates frogs.
Oh.
Yeah, we did not find anything froggy related. I remember that now. The F and Rog, which is like, come on. It could be like a full Poggerla Rog. Might be better just to lose and go try to find the thing.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. We want to learn if we can.
If she's got 20 HP, we could probably beat her without it.
Although,
maybe not.
Goomba can't do any damage.
Mario's dead.
Oh!
Being that he's made out of paper, the fight. Wow, it's a fairy is what that is.
That's pretty cool.
But it stinks that we used it.
Yeah.
So I'm really hoping.
Except, do you think it'll be gone?
When we load a save? I don't think so. F and ends with Rog. I bet it's in that cracked wall, but how do you get through that? Is there a bomb item that we can... have the hammer.
Yeah, because it only does 1 damage per, so the defense...
Yeah.
Okay, so, I mean, we're learning...
Coops. Coops is the way to go. Coops, poops.
Now that we know what we know.
That's with the guard did 4?
Oh. Yeah, because the guard only reduces by 1.
Oh, I didn't know that. Well, now I know.
Yeah, it's just like a flat attack power versus defense power, and your defense power goes up by 1.
Did we get a release date for that Mario and Luigi game that's coming out?
Ooh, I don't know.
I'm going to look it up, because that's going to be a similar sort of situation to this, except hopefully it's 2-player.
That's another benefit to Basement Let's Play, is I see games that are coming up, and I'm like, I don't want to not play that, and I want to talk while I'm playing it and give my thoughts, you know? And I want someone to hear them. So if it weren't for Basement Let's Play... My wife would have to watch me play every new Nintendo first party-ish game that comes out.
It's 2024, probably holiday.
Yeah, and Yacht Club's new game is coming out.
Oh, cool. The little...
Mine of the Hollower?
Yeah, that looks cool.
Okay, now Mario's dead for good. Hey, what do I do now? I'm just a Koopa.
Now you die.
All right, next time in the basement, we're going to look for a frog.
Yes.
Until next time, basement dwellers, we think that you are more starting with an F and ending with an R-O-G than...
November 7th, 2024, which is the release date of Mario and Luigi Brothership.
Oh. In the basement.